Welcome to our comprehensive tutorial on how to restart an Abaqus analysis. In this video, we'll cover the essential steps and key considerations for effectively restarting an analysis in Abaqus. This powerful feature enables users to continue a previous analysis, saving significant time and computational resources. Let's dive into the process and applications of restart analysis. Today's presentation will include several key points. We'll start with the basic concepts of restarting an analysis and then explore various applications. After that, we'll discuss how to request restart files, followed by the steps to initiate a restart analysis. We'll also cover how to configure restart files and wrap up with some important considerations and a conclusion. When restarting an analysis in Abaqus, there are several crucial points to keep in mind. First, ensure that restart files are requested before running the initial analysis. This is done through the step module by selecting Output and then Restart Requests. Next, in your new analysis, reference the step of the previous job to be used as the starting point in the model attributes. It's also important to note that you can continue an interrupted job as originally defined or add additional steps, though new geometry cannot be included. Finally, select Restart when running the restart analysis as the job type. The .odb file of the restart analysis will only contain data on the newly simulated steps. Restart analysis is beneficial in various scenarios. For example, it allows the analysis of a model's behavior under different loadings with the same pre-loading step, which needs to be simulated only once. It is also useful when encountering convergence issues in a later step, as modifications can be made without rerunning the entire analysis. Additionally, if an analysis fails due to external factors such as power outages, only the last part of the analysis needs to be simulated. To request restart files, planning ahead is crucial. You need to decide to obtain restart files before running the first analysis. In the CAE, go to the step module, select Output, and then Restart Requests. Here, you can set the output frequency or the number of intervals per step. You might consider using the overlay or time marks options as needed. Once the job is run, a .res restart file will be generated among the output files. Initiating the restart analysis involves several steps. Start by copying the original model in the .cae file to use as a basis for the restart analysis. Right-click the model in the model tree and select Edit Attributes. Tick Read Data from Job and specify the previous job name and restart location. Then, define additional steps as needed, keeping in mind that changes to elements like geometry or material properties from previous steps are not allowed. Finally, create a new job, selecting Restart as the job type in the Edit Job dialog box, and run the job to complete the restart analysis. Configuring restart files includes setting the frequency, intervals, overlay, and time marks. Determine how often restart files are written, and set the number of equally spaced points in time for output. For example, setting 10 means 10 equally spaced points. Decide if new data should overwrite old data, which can limit file size, and specify output at exact time points, which may increase simulation time. As we conclude, keep these key considerations in mind. Always plan ahead and request restart files in advance to ensure they're available when needed. Remember the limitations. Restart can only include modifications possible in a single analysis. Adding constraints, geometry, or changing material properties is not possible. Note that output files from the initial and restart analyses are not combined automatically. Despite these limitations, using the restart function can significantly save time in many scenarios. Now, let's move on to a practical demonstration. We'll go through an actual Abaqus model simulation to explain and show the details and steps involved in restarting an analysis. Following explanations, I have prepared a model for you to better understand the restart option in the Abaqus files. I will explain the model and then the restart option in this model. Also, here I will explain the matters that I have explained to you in the past for better understanding and more accurate analysis. In the beginning, the model that I have simulated is the deep drawing process model. This model includes a punch, a die, a blank holder, and the sheet that we want to form. Now, after modeling this process, to explain the points that we must consider reaching the restart option in Abaqus, we should go to the step modulus. First, let me explain this process to you. In this simulation, as you can see, we have two steps. The first step, which takes less time, is about loading on the sheet utilizing the blank holder, which presses our sheet downwards and prevents it from moving beyond its limit because of punch displacement. And in the second step, our punch moves downwards as I explained, and the forming process is done. Now what we are going to do is, once this process is done in such a way that the blank holder force remains fixed in the first step and a special force is applied, and in the second step, our punch moves downwards by 50 millimeters and the formation is done. Then, to reach the restart option, we make a copy of this model, and in that copy model only and only step 2 is done, and this time, the punch moves down 25 millimeters instead of 50. This is one of the applications of the restart option in Abaqus, which I explained to you. When you have multiple steps and your first step is fixed, and for example you just want your second step to move with different amounts, you can use this option, and we will use the restart option for this purpose. After that, in the load module, the displacement of the punch is applied, and the modeling is done. Now what we must pay attention to is that in the model we have, in the step module and in the output tab, as explained, we have a choice under the name of restart request. As our solver is the explicit solver, the options that we have include intervals, overlay, and time marks. I explained to you these options and what these are used for completely in the PowerPoint presentation section. I want to restart from the first step and create a new one. I want to use it for the new runs and new jobs. As a result, I put the number of intervals for my first step on 10, for example, from the first step to the next. These settings are for our first and main models. Here, I have created job 1, from this model that you can see here. The attention that for job 1, the job type is set as full analysis. We will change these settings for job 2 in the following. As you can see in the status bar, my model is complete, and we will see its results in the following. But what should we do for the restart option? As you can see, I have a model here under the name of job 2, which is the same model copied from job 1, and I haven't changed it. Instead, I just want to explain to you that in job 1, my punch goes down by 50 millimeters. In job 2, it goes down by 25 millimeters. As a result, I only changed this amount of punch displacement in the boundary condition section of the module load, and I didn't make any other changes to the model. Note that the boundary conditions and geometry of my model do not change and remain constant. After the changes were made to the displacement of model 2, which we copied from model 1, right-click on the job 2 model and select edit attributes. In the open window, in the restart tab, I have activated the read data from job option. As you can see, this option is activated. I have selected read data from job, specifically job 1, which is related to my reference model as I created a job from it. I want my simulation to start after step 1, as indicated by activating the restart from the end of the step option and specifying step 1 here. By activating this option and specifying step 1, it means that my second model uses the data from step 1 in the first model and then solves from there to the next step. You can now activate the restart from increment, interval, iteration, or cycle option in the output section of the step 1 settings, which is related to any of its increments, provided that you have given the request. Now, I have created another job here. As you can see, the new job type is related to the job 2 model, and it is a restart. In this window, which is linked to the information for job 2, you can observe that the job type is set to restart. The job type for our first model was full analysis, while for our second model, it is restart. These are the settings for you to be able to use the restart option of Abaqus. You must activate it before you run any of your models and execute. Then, to access the results, I will go to the visualization module and check the existing models. I have two models here, one related to job 1 and the other related to job 2. We want to analyze the restart file option results here. The model on the left is related to model 1, where the punch displacement was set to 50 millimeters. I will zoom in on this model to provide a clearer view. Pay attention that we are in step 1. With the movement of the increments forward, there is only one force from the blank holder to this sheet and no movement of the punch in step 1. Moving to step 2, the punch moves downwards and the sheet forming is completed until the end of step 2 when our punch moves downwards by 50 millimeters. In our second model, our job and our results started at the beginning of step 2. Here our sheet is under loading and the amount of stress created in our sheet is visible. The sheet is pushed downwards by the blank holder. To explain the topic more precisely, observe the last increments of step 1 to see the amount of stress in the sheet. In the second model, this is the first increment of step 2, and when we move the increments forward, you can see that the punch moves down in job 2 less than in job 1. This option is useful in situations where we can analyze two models at the same time and compare the results by changing parameters, saving time, and having positive effects on our project's runtime. Thank you for your attention to this video.